Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. In my last video tutorial, I showed you how to go beyond the 6x speed and reverse settings, and we're going to pick up from where we left off, and in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add a simple zoom blur, but also use keyframes so that you can track it through to your point of focus. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is highlight the clip, and then from there we're going to make a duplicate. If we double tap on the duplicate and then go to blending, and you want to reduce the opacity to around about between 65 and 75% depending on your preference. We'll start off at 75%. Now you're not going to notice much difference at the moment because the video layer underneath is obviously identical. Then what we're going to do is just go to the beginning of that video clip and we're going to tap on our pencil icon. Go to color and effects, go to our blur droplet icon, just search through until you find zoom blur. Now you can start with a short zoom blur, go for zoom or long zoom, it doesn't really matter because you're going to fine tune it anyway. So for argument's sake, I'm just going to start with a short zoom blur. Now what you're then going to do is you need to decide where you are looking in terms of your point of focus for the zoom blur. So I mean, if we have it down here, you'll see that window becomes the point of zoom, but in my case, I actually want it to be the St. Andrew's flag. You can then decide on how much blur is going on. Now what I usually do is start at 2 or 3 and build it up. Because what we're going to do is add keyframes. So the first keyframe is going to be 0. You're then going to move along 1 frame and then bring it up to 1. And it starts the process of increasing the zoom blur. And at all times, make sure that you're over your point of focus. And then you're going to get another frame, bring it up to 2. And again, just making sure that you're covering your point of focus. And then another frame. Once we get to 3, the first sort of 4 frames in total, 0, 1, 2, and 3. We then want to skip 2 frames and then increase the effect. So 1, 2, go to 4. Again, just make sure that you're over your point of focus. 1, 2, tap the amount up to 5. 1, 2, up to 6. Now, if you're quite happy with this being 6, leave it at 6. You don't need to go beyond that. But what I'm going to do is, just as I get further into closer to the castle, I'm actually going to increase the amount of blur a little bit more. So we're just going to do 1, 2, and drop another keyframe, keeping it at 6. But again, making sure we are directly over that flag. 1, 2, drop another keyframe, reposition the zoom blur if needs be, and then 1, 2, we're getting closer now. And I think on the next one, we will increase things speed-wise. 1, 2, bring it up to 7, and reposition over the flag, and then we'll leave it at 7 for a bit. So I'm just going to fast forward through this bit. So I'm just going to do literally 1, 2, drop a keyframe. Just go back and just check that I'm quite happy with the flag position. Drop a keyframe because the flag position doesn't need moved. It's a 2 second clip in total, 2 seconds, 18 frames. So once we get to here, I want to start slowing things down a bit. It's getting quite close to our point of focus. So I'm going to drop this one back to 6. Then we go 1, 2, check our position, go to 5, 1, 2, reposition. Leave it at 5 for this one, 1, 2, and then lower it to 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Frames along, reposition to the middle of the flag, go to 2, hold it at 2, so 1, 2 frames along, just reposition the zoom blur, not that there's much there at the moment, 1, 2, and again, I'm just going to drop this now to 1, and then 2 more frames along, and this is going to go to 0, and then all you've got to do is go to the end and hold that at 0. Make sure that's at 0, there we go, and then if we go right to the beginning, let's take a look at the effect now, and you'll see, because we've keyframed it, get quite a smooth effect, and the flag is still quite sharp. What really sells it though, is a little bit of audio. So if we switch on a whoosh sound effect I've got here, the flight of the drone, if you watch again, kind of goes from left to right. So what you can do is not only add the whoosh sound effect, but if we actually go into the edit itself, so we're going to go into the audio settings, make sure you're at the beginning of the video clip and drop a keyframe. We're then going to go into the pan and drag over to the left hand side. We're then going to go to the end of the clip and drag everything over to the right hand side. You end up with this line effect. I also seem to have a keyframe in the gain, so we'll just get rid of that. Don't need that. And that just means that it goes from left to right in the pan, and it's just a nice sort of, you know, motion of sound through your headphones or your speakers. So if we play this now, you should have, if you're listening with headphones, felt that through your left ear into your right ear. If you've got speakers, surround sound system, you will have noticed the sound navigating across. Now, to sell it just a little bit more, we're going to go into speed. And we're just going to crank up our speed to around about, let's say, 1.1. Now, I'm going to see how it sounds without maintaining the audio pitch. If it sounds okay, I'll leave it. If not, I'll come back in and flick this little switch here on. So you'll see at 1.1, 110%, the whoosh has sort of lined up with the video clip. It's a good guess, give or take a frame. Let's see what it sounds like. I don't dislike it, but let's just go back into it again and see what it's like with the maintaining the audio pitch. I could prefer the slightly higher version, so we'll switch that off, and that's us pretty much done. You can just go in and just trim that to the end, and here's the overall effect one last time. And as I say, for this kind of zoom effect, you're probably going to want to speed ramp it, so it does kind of slow down towards the end anyway, but if I was working this clip for an actual video, I'd probably take out a segment either end of the video and then speed up, slow down, and just speed ramp it a little bit. Probably do a video on that. Speed ramping is coming to LumaFusion this year sometime, don't know exactly when, and when it arrives, we will maybe revisit this video tutorial or look at another one and do it with the speed ramping in place. But I think I'm going to do another video tutorial, and we're just going to break everything down that we've learned in this video and in the previous 6 times speed barrier video, and we're also going to speed ramp it as well, because I haven't looked at speed ramp for a while. And I will catch you on the next one. See you later.
If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, as it really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more video tutorials every week, and ring the bell to get notified of when Stu has uploaded a new video tutorial. You have been watching I Am Stu. See you later.